Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of the Minecraft Redstone Projects, and today I have made what you see before you. This is a way to compose music within the game of Minecraft. So as you can see here, we have long notes and short notes, and we have the entire piano layout like you would see on a normal keyboard, as you can see in this photo right here. It compares kind of to that. And you can simply place notes along and it'll play them as it runs through left to right like you would in music composing software. So let me give a demonstration. To start out, you have the control panel. This, you can start the music, which starts the thing cascading across. Don't worry if it looks jumpy. It actually isn't jumpy. That's just the way Minecraft renders it. It's actually going smoothly across. And you can stop it to make it go back. And also, you can step on any of these golden pressure plates to make it skip to where you are and start playing from there. Now, you can hit the Get Blocks button if you don't have the blocks already, but I do. And also, you can clear the entire board over here, but be warned, this cannot be undone, as you can see there in the little text. You click that, and it clears all the stuff on the entire board. And you may be wondering, what's all that up in the sky? Well, that actually is a preset song that can be cloned onto the board. Now, if we come over here, we can see songs, and the only one I have so far is Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. If people really want more songs to start out, I will add them in the future, but this is the only one as of now. So if I click it, you can see it clones that from up there down to here, and so now we can play it, and let me give you a little demonstration of how it sounds. And there it is. That is my rendition of Twinkle Twinkle Little Star recreated into Minecraft using this. So, as you can see, the piano sounds are actually very high quality, and they don't use the actual Minecraft built-in noises. They're all custom sounds that I had to add individually one by one, which takes a long time to do. And if any of you guys are really good at making custom resource packs where you can have custom sounds... Oh, I accidentally stepped on that. But yeah, as you can see, that works pretty good. You step on it, and it starts playing from where you are. That way, it's actually very useful. Like, say you want to try this, you want to see how this sounds, you step on here, and oh, that sounds terrible. Let me stop that, fix this up, change it up, and then you step back over here. Yeah, that sounds good, and then you can continue going from there. Just edit and continue and make your melody. Now, I am planning to create a save and load feature so you can save whatever you have on here to save slot 1 through 10. I'm hoping to have about 10 save slots so you can hit a button in the book and save it, and it gets saved somewhere and you can work on something else and then you can load it back up again. And also, we have got these timings. So in music, there is a beat, right? There's 4-4, 3-4. I'm just going with 4-4 here because really, to make it so it would be adjusted, that would require a lot of work in the control panel and adding multiple layers so that they could be cloned back and forth. I could potentially do it, only if you guys really wanted me to. It would be a ton of work. Basically, adjusting anything on this map is a ton of work. As you can see, guys, it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And so the red represents every time it goes 1. It's a very, very slow beat. But there's also a lot of fill-in space here, so you can fill in quite a bit here. So the notes can go decently fast, but just not super fast. And also make sure you have your render distance on 16. If you can't do 16, then you might need to stand in the middle of the board to clear and add songs, because you need to be able to render all the way at the end and all the way at the beginning to be able to place songs and also clear the entire board. And if you've never made music before, this just so you know, the bottom here is the lower notes, and the notes get higher as you go up, and that's basically all it is. It's just a piano. Lower notes down here, higher notes up here, and yeah, you can just, as you can hear this note right there, and then if we come all the way up here, and we place this one, that one's pretty high up. And if you want, I can make an entire scale going all the way down. All right, there's the scale. Let's listen to the scale. Yeah, it doesn't sound the best. And also, this thing is about teleporting armor stands. It's kind of, it can be slightly laggy at sometimes. So the thing is about this map, because this map is a void world, you get great FPS. So what I would recommend doing, if you're having a bit of lag issues where the song is stuttering, go to video settings and limit your frame rate down to 60. And if that doesn't help, go lower, because that will free up your processor. Oh, now it's all choppy. But lowering your max FPS will free up enough resources that it might be able to play it in real time. Instead of using all of your computer resources to just crank the frames per second, it'll use it to play the music instead. Now, if you want to know how the redstone works, as you can see, it's fairly simple. There's not really much here. And did I stop this? Actually, if you don't stop the music, it'll automatically reset when it gets to the end and stop, but all by itself, so you don't need to worry about that. And as you can see, all this glass is encased. Actually, well, this will be covered when you get the map. But down here, there is not much here. It's a pretty simple build. So these two things work when you stop the music. It places it here and runs this set of command blocks, which what they do is that they make that redstone go away, which is, this is the command block that makes all the armor stands teleport. So it gets rid of this redstone, and so the armor stands stop moving. And along with that, it also gets rid of the redstone block, and it also teleports all the armor stands back to the beginning. When you start the music, all that happens is it places the block on that. Oh, and now it's playing the scale again. But yeah, it just places the redstone dust here when you click start music. And to get blocks, you can see right here, it does place a redstone block right there, and then it gets rid of the redstone blocks, and it gives you hardened clay and wool. So hardened clay and wool with the name short note and long note. Pretty simple there. And what this is doing, it's trying to see if there's any armor stands on top of stone brick, and there's actually stone brick at the very end. You can see it there. And if the armor stands get all the way back to the end and get on top of that stone brick, it'll teleport them back to the beginning, so that they won't go off into the void and deload themselves and break the whole map, which can happen. And here is where the main magic happens. This map uses a custom resource pack that is actually built into the world, so you don't need to add a custom resource pack or anything. It's automatically applied when you open the world. Now, there is one block here for every single note in the game. So these are for the regular notes, and these are for the sharps and flats. These are for the long, these are for the short, and these are for the long flats, these are for the short flats. And this is how many times per second they are executed at. So, as you can see, this and this are both running at the same speed. So every single time it moves forward, which is what this command block does, this will try and see if there's a block underneath the armor stands that play the note. So that armor stand way down there at the left, its name is 1, just the number 1. And so as you can see here, this command block is trying to execute at an armor stand that is named 1, as you can see there, and it's trying to detect a piece of wool under it. And if it's wool 11, which is blue wool, it'll play sound normal 1, which is what I called the sound of the piano note, and the category is master, and it plays it to all players within any coordinates and with a volume of 100. So that way, it's pretty much full volume, but it won't play it to anyone that's 1,000 blocks away. Not that it really, really matters. And it's the same exact thing for everything else. The next armor stand over there will be called number 2. And the armor stand named 2 will look for a piece of wool underneath it. And if that armor stand finds a piece of wool underneath it, it'll play it as well. A way I can demonstrate this is when the armor stands are not moving, such as right now. So as you probably guessed, these are all armor stands with glass on their heads that are invisible and aren't affected by gravity. And if I place this under here, as you can hear, it's playing it over and over and over again. But normally it just skips right over it, so it only plays it once. And yeah. So now I can give you a main idea of what the long notes versus short notes sound like. And the short one. So there's really not a huge difference. There's a lot of reverb behind both, but the short notes are just a little bit shorter and the long ones are a bit more drawn out. I may make them a little more pronounced. I may make the long ones longer and the short ones shorter, although it requires a lot of work basically to update anything in this map. And if you guys want something like an electric guitar version of the map, or me to add a drum track or something like that, keep in mind that adding anything will cause more lag, and people with not that great computers will not be able to do this unless they have it hosted on a server or something that's somewhere far away. But then server lag and ping issues could make the music not be in time. So it's best to do this in single player, but without a powerful computer, sometimes the notes can get off key. But like I said, limiting your frame rate can definitely help and make it so that it plays without stuttering. So that's pretty much it for this redstone project. Make your own music. Make whatever. You can recreate Beethoven's music. You can recreate the Minecraft music. I think this is pretty cool. It might be a useful tool to teach people, to teach kids about music possibly, and things like that. And if you've never really gotten into music making, maybe you'll like it, and you can try it on this map. And if you do like it, you can try using real software in the future. I tried to recreate what real software is like in Minecraft, where the scrolling bar along the side and the music notes along a grid, that's really what normal software does. And so yeah, that's really all there is. I went over everything as best as I could. And if you did enjoy it, remember to leave a like. And if you know someone that might be interested in this project, make sure to give the video a share, or just share it with them personally. Whatever works. But again, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye, everyone. Woo! Oh, yeah.